Hello, I'm Benza from the Witcher 3 REDkit team, and I'm gonna show you around today how to get started with the REDkit as a mod creator. I'll quickly show you how to download it, how to load words, and how to navigate the editor. After this video, later on we will have more advanced tutorials broken down by topics, so stay tuned for them, and I will hope you will have as much fun creating mods as we had creating the REDkit. So first of all, on your respective storefront, Steam, GOG, or EGS, you have to navigate to the REDkit product and add it to your library. It is free to download, but you have to own The Witcher 3 for it to work. So first of all, when you launch the REDkit, you will be presented with this welcome screen. So what this does is, first you have to get the data from the game that the REDkit will use. Just to be fair, this is for when you are creating mods. We will have a different video for installing mods. So here you have to select two directories. The first one is the Witcher 3 directory. This is the main folder where you have all your content. So basically, if you install it to a Steam library folder, then you will have a different path, but essentially the end should be the Witcher 3. The other one is the depot directory. This folder is basically used for holding the data that we unpack from the game. When you first select this, you will see here that the depot is invalid and you will have to click generate. If you have an HDD or some slower PC, this can very well take a few minutes to up to an hour, but you only have to do this once. This will unpack the data from the game, and once you have it, then REDkit will use this to load all your levels and present you models and such. So just to double check yourself, once this generate finished, you should have a file, a JSON, which lists all your files that are there, and here should be a bunch of folders, a bunch of data. It should be around, if I'm correct, 50 gigabytes. So make sure that everything is correct. So once this is finished, you can move on and create a project. So both for the depot and for your projects, I would recommend to create a completely new empty folder outside of the Witcher 3 installation or anything else. So maybe you can just make a folder on your D drive called modding, and then create a folder Witcher 3 depot and Witcher 3 projects. Okay, so I already have a project prepared. Once you create more projects, you will be able to select them here. So I will just open up this one. And in a couple seconds, it will load up. Every time the editor loads up, it recompiles the script and verifies everything for you. So during your modding, sometimes you will have a pop-up here that will show you if you have broken something, but usually there is a help text showing you how to resolve it. So this is our main view. It consists of the main viewport where you will be able to load your levels, play the game, and test your mods. And here we have all our tools, and on the top and on the left side, you have these common buttons that you can use. So to start us off, the most important thing is this button. So this will open up this window called the Asset Browser, which is basically the file browser for Witcher 3. To help you a bit get an idea, this contains all the files that are used by the game. So for example, if we go to characters, play NPC entities, then main NPC, then for example, we have the young Siri here, which you can open up and see how she looks like. You can just change the lights a bit. So, as the basic, I guess, thing that you can do is you can go to the levels folder. Then, for example, open up the Vizima castle. And you have these like purple edged files, which is called W2W, which you can open up. And this will, in the main view, load you up the Vizima board. So to move around here with the camera, with the left click, you can drag around the camera. And with the right click, you can look around. You can also use WASD to move yourself around, but it will be pretty slow. So what is really helpful is when you're pressing W, you can scroll to make the camera faster, or you can press Shift to go really fast. But as you can see, we don't really have much. We have just cold terrain and everything is empty. So here on the right side, we have the scene hierarchy. And as you can see, Vizima Castle is atop. If you click on any of them, you can see all the parameters that you can change. So if you go to the top and you click and you right click, and you can press load all in group, which will load everything in the level. If you give it a couple seconds, it should give you all the castle. These purple and green things are debug areas, triggers, and a lot of things that you will be able to learn in our other videos. You can press this brush to disable them, and you can here move around as usual. So one thing that I also want to show you is we have this button which will load up the game with Geralt for you. And you will be able to walk around the level and test your things. So as you will be editing your level, you will be able to just anytime drop your character in and test how everything works, as it's actually the game. So everything is real time and you will be able to test everything. And once you're here, to exit, you have to press the F10 button, which will return you to the basic view that we had before. So this is the basics. We will have more other advanced videos, but you can, together with the documentation, you can get started with this. So I hope you will have fun modding, and thank you for your attention.